Hey there, everyone. It's time for another part of Pokemon Crystal Apria. So, in the last part, we became the Pokemon League champion. We went to the Indigo Plateau. Well, we was already there. We progressed through the Indigo Plateau and defeated the Elite Four and a champion Shockslayer. And also a Swinub. And we also caught a Snorlax in the National Park in Johto. So, we currently have 12 badges, we've got 4 left. We have Whitney in Johto, then we've got Misty, Erica, and Blaine in Kanto. So I was going to start out with one of the gym leaders, but I stumbled upon a new trainer to fight. So I'm in Pallet Town in Kanto, and after you beat the game, if you come to Red's house, you can talk to his mother. Oh, looking for Red? Well, all kids leave home someday. I have heard that there's a powerful trainer deep down inside Mount Silver. I'm sure it's my beloved Red. But if it's a powerful trainer you're looking for, I can fill the part. So yeah, we can fight Red's mother. I hope you're ready for this. So, a funny thing is... Well, not funny. A interesting thing about this game is, depending on the character that you are, or it might just be who you start as, but that will also depend on who is at Mount Silver. So since I've picked Ethan, then Red's going to be there. I believe if you pick Red, then Ethan will be in Mount Silver instead. So I don't know if you can fight his mother. Not 100% sure on that, but yeah. But Red's mother with the friggin' original champion theme. That's certainly a choice that I didn't expect, but here we... Of course. Fucking Mr. Mime. Yeah, I've got no idea what a team is. I just knew that you could fight her. I didn't realise I'd be a fucking Mr. Mime. Let alone the damn lead. So, Mr. Mime's got pretty good special defense, so I don't think a Giga Drain's gonna do too much. Especially with the 10 level deficit I have. This is just a lead, I'm curious what the... what level the Ace is going to be. And what the Ace is actually going to be as well. I mean... Oh, yeah, that didn't do much. I'm guessing it's going to be, like, a Persian, because, like, you know, cats. Yeah, that is, I wasn't expecting to do much, but, like, that is really not a lot. Oh, yeah, the light screen was up. This might actually KO now. Not quite. I'll just use Substitute again. Planned that pretty well, because I'm guessing that it's going to destroy myself. Yep. Oh, wait, no, it's not going to go back up to the Leech Seed. Damn it. Oh, well. Next is... Tauros! 81, holy crap, that might be the Ace instead. It's going to be faster than me. It might have Flamethrower or Blizzard. Mega Horn, ooh. I think I can take that. Ooh, barely. Alright, let's get it to sleep. I've got enough for a sub, just... Okay. Yeah, Spore it again. Have enough now. Right, let me see. Ooh. Okay. Right, that Mega Horn's gonna kill me, so let me. Do you we still have the Bright Powder. Yeah. 109 defense. 208, but you're weak to it, so. He might survive if he gets hit by it. If he gets hit by a double edge, then no, but he might survive a Mega Horn, just barely. Yes, he did. Nice. Good job to D. Then... that's the thing. Tauros is, like, not slow. Fast, as you might say. So, with this level disadvantage, I might not outspeed. And even if I do outspeed, what do I actually want to do? Like, why did I bring this guy in? Like, Earthquake for damage, Tri-Attack for potential status, Rock Slide to flinch if I'm faster, Sludge Bomb for poison. I don't know. Just Earthquake. Yeah. All that musing and the... yeah, just outspeeds anyway. Alright. King, let's do this. Should rename this guy to God because of how he performed in the league. Like, holy crap. Ah! Poison him to get some more residual damage on. I might just survive. Ooh, barely. Right, give me my HP back, please. I need it. But you got a gold berry? Yeah. It's only 30 HP recovery, so it's not... a big deal. But, ooh, this is gonna kill her. Right. Who's next? Oh, wait, that wasn't a race. That was only a second one. Primeir. Level 77. Does Primeir get Earthquake in Gen 2? I don't think so. I mean, it might. I've just never used it. Mach Punch. Interesting. Boomerang. Yeah, it's no Earthquake, but it is a ground move. Why Boomerang? It's a monkey. Fine. You want a ground move? I'll give you one.
Self-destruct! Excuse me?
Okay. What, it just explodes with anger or some shit? That... okay. Sure, whatever. A win's a win, I guess. Fira. Okay, that's... not too... distressing. And then it starts spamming double team, okay. I'm surprised I'm faster than it actually. Cause like Fira isn't slow. King Glare, alright. Vic Slide! Oh my god. Some of the moves they give him and give certain things are just wacky, like it's bad! Like, a very scrawny looking bad. What, you think it's just gonna pick up rocks with its talons and throw them on other stuff? Like, I even found it weird that friggin'... what's it called? Bombardier. That Bombardier can friggin' learn Rock Slide and shit, but it gets that ability that... like, gives it stab on rock moves, but... Hero! Like, look how scrawny it is! Right, I'm gonna... actually, no. I'm gonna switch to Lani. I swear to God, if they give it fucking Earthquake... Like, that'll be absolutely dumb. Yeah, let's see your belt. Cure Fubuki of that paralysis. And I just get paralyzed again, but... Line's slow anyway, so it's not that big a deal. It's just going to be annoying if I can't attack. Oh my god. Right, let me just cure it, because it is going to get annoying. It really is annoying. Now, Rockslide's also got a... Oh my god. A 30% chance to flinch, so... It makes for a good parafusion strategy as well. Like, Thunder Wave and Headbutt. Alright, let's get rid of this thing now. Kindly get out of my life. You know Rock Slide can miss, right? Oh my god. Drill Peck, it must be out of Rock Slides now. Ow! So what's it got? Rock Slide, Glare. Drill Peck. Something else stupid, probably. Alright, down goes that bird. What have we got left? We've got two or three left? Two. Victory Bell! Ugh. 77. It's probably gonna Giga Drain. Let me put a light screen up just before Lana goes down. Oh no, Sludge Bomb. I mean, it's fine, it works. Alright, Fubuki, get in here. Kill this thing. Actually, Victory Bell might survive it. It can be bulky. Yeah. Ben. Damn. Right. I can't compare speeds here. Yeah, thing about Gen 2 is you can't check your stats before you send something in. You have to do it straight away. Nudes, I guess. Get a bit of left as a good rate right now, let me check. So, I want to check speed. 128. 141. Wow, you're pretty speedy, aren't you? And 111. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be faster than this. Nope, that's probably going to kill now. Since, it's super effective, instead. That means, Dunsparce isn't outspeeding. And probably going to go down, so... Alright, time to bust out the items. I would have preferred not to, but... I'm left with no choice. Well, I do have a choice. I could either use items or I could lose, and I don't fancy losing. Right, it's got one more after this, so let me set up a reflect. Maybe get the damage up. Super Fang! I mean, yeah, it's got fangs, I guess, but... Whatever. Right, I'll get Rudra. So Super Fang doesn't actually deal. Ooh, doesn't deal damage. It halves the current HP of the hit target. That's why it did so much. Right. What is your ace? Oh, that. Lapras. Definitely glad I brought Heracross back. You and your Pokemon are looking great. Yeah. Thanks, I guess, even though you've killed most of them. Wait, why is this only level 73? Whatever, just a flamethrower. Yeah, the... Like, just some of the trainer levels are really weird. Like, I said it last time, but I don't know, it's just like a really prevalent thing. Oh my god, a crit. It's just a really prevalent thing. Like, she started out with a 77 Mr. Mime, she had an 81 Tauros, and now this Lapras is just 73 for whatever reason. I don't know, just... Like, when I changed the levels in my Emerald one, I made them, like, pretty consistent on, like, the same trainer. Good job, Rudra, you did it. It's been a long time since I lost. Oh, that's a lot of money! I won't be as strong as I am without losing. Although I know Red would have been far more challenging. Yeah, you and your Pokemon should take a rest. You're looking great. Take care out there. Thanks. So... Yeah, let me just head to Newbark Town. And... I want to check to see if Ethan's mother will fight me as well. Okay, Newbark Town. Gold, whatever. Gold Ethan, like it matters. I worry about Gold getting hurt or sick, but I'm proud that he's doing what he wants to do. Good evening, I'm visiting. My daughter is adamant about becoming Professor Elm's assistant. She loves Pokemon. I mean, that's nice, but I want to fight him, but... Okay. Right, I guess not. Hey, what? The arena? What the fuck is this? Hi? Underground Arena Hall of Fame. Someone named Cosmo is listed at the top. Alright. Several ban lists. Legends. Articuno, Zapdos, Moltres, Mew, Raikou, Inter, Suicune, Ho-Oh, Lugia, Celebi. Okay. Pidgeot Tournament. Starmie, Snorlax, Zapdos, Mewtwo, Mew, Blissey, Raikou, Suicune, Lugia, Ho-Oh, Celebi. Moves. Sonic Boom, Dragon Rage, Rest, Double Team, Minimize, Minlock. I don't use any of them anyway. Bright Powder is banned in all formats, and Gold Berry is banned in Little Cup. Okay. Go back to Youth PC, set rules. Scaled 5. Alright. Use the PC over there to get ready for your matches. I've been reading the manual for the set rules screen. Pressing select makes changing the difficulty faster. It's a new model, so it's real fancy. Don't ask me where I got it. I mean, that's nice. Can you tell me what the fuck this place is? You choose which rule set you want to battle under. You keep battling until you forfeit or get knocked out of the ring. Every 5 battles, you get a heal and 1 extra point to your total. You lose, you get kicked out of the ring until the next day. Scaled levels gives XP, but less points. All levels give stat experience. That sounds right, okay. Laptop, Booster Ball, Applicator, Leaf Pack, Nugget. Well, this is obviously like a Silver Leaf and a Gold Leaf. I don't know what any of the other things are. Oh, okay, there's Wobbuffet. Alright, I'm gonna look up what those items are, so just give me a moment. Okay then, I am back after some research. So the laptop is pretty much what it says on the tin. It's a portable PC. You can access your PC options at any time. The Booster Ball boosts DVs of Pokemon that you catch with it. I don't know if it makes them all 15 or if it increases them by a set amount, but... Yeah, that could be good if you don't fancy chaining to look for a perfect DV mod. And the applicator makes it so that you don't have a limit on using vitamins on your mons. Normally you can only feed up to 10 of each for a total of however many it gives, however many points it gives in this. This basically just removes that limit, so you can use vitamins to just max out your stat experience on everything. What do you say?
The Bouncer!
You sure you got what it takes to be here? The underground arena is only for the toughest of trainers. Granted, people from all over come to battle, so we started supporting more stuff.
I can just go through. I can talk to others.
Copycat! Familiar? No? Yes? Maybe? People call me Copycat. Don't worry, I won't mimic you without your permission. Recently, I've been doing what's called mirror matches. Interested in fighting yourself?
That's what I was going to say.
Interesting.
Am I strong enough to beat myself, Sedge? No.
Hey, Challenger!
Are you ready to rumble?
I guess.
Let me take a look at your party.
You have multiple leftovers. That's against the item clause. Alright. Is that just a legal checker? If you can fight in here? Oh, finding this place was tough. Well, a secret underground arena should be. Especially since the cops shut down battles before. Fortunately, the powers that be bribed the crew that connected the two underground paths, which let us move all this stuff undetected. So keep your mouth shut. Don't ruin a good thing for the community. Alright, dickhead. You know what? Sure, why not? Truly, the greatest opponent I must overcome is myself. Fight me. Okay, let's get started. Oh, I'm liking this. Oh, it's me! Hello! This is gonna Dunspass. How tragic. Oh, he's so close to the next level. Are items banned? They are. Ooh, okay, right, good to know. Right. Low toxic. Thunderwave, you bitch. You can do this, King. I believe in you. My king, not that king. Eat this music, whatever it is. No idea what it's from, but it's quite funky. Oh yeah, let's get nudes in here. It's not going to status me after on the Switch, because yeah, Dunspass is already paralyzed. So it's got no reason to go for it. Actually, let me just Giga Drain. I might be able to kill it from here. I imagine that Fubuki's gonna come in next. Right, there goes King. Yeah, no experience, I figured that. Ooh, Heracross. Right, let me leech seed it. Mega Horn, yeah. Down goes the sub. Up go the seeds. Fine by me. Right. Yeah, that's the thing. I don't really have anything to tank Rudra. Actually, is Ninetales fast enough? Why is everything so close to leveling up? 185. 161, okay. So that's the good thing. I know how fast these guys are because I can just check. It's probably going to survive a photo, so I'm going to stick a Reflector up. because obviously Earthquake's coming. No stab on it, so I might survive with a Reflex, but yeah, okay, that's good. And hopefully I can take him out with a Flamethrower, but I'm not confident that I will. Nope, okay. I should survive this Earthquake. Yep, okay, that's fine. Yeah, shame that I don't have a... Oh, wait. I was going to say it's a shame I don't have a flying type to switch into, but no, I have Nudes. Physical attack, reflect, resisted. This Earthquake's going to do jack shit. Unless it crits, which, you know, will be unfortunate, but no. There we go, nice. There's Fubuki. Okay. Well, the obvious play is to switch Lani in and surf it to death. Because there isn't much it can do against Lani. Like, Flamethrower's not going to do much. And, like, what else is he going to do? Psychic? Icy Wind? I'm already slower. Let me stick up a light screen. Just to reduce incoming damage. Then surf away. And the good thing about this mirror... Oh my god, I didn't know. The good thing about this mirror match is, like, all my levels are, like, fairly close together. So it is, like, pretty much a dead even fight, because I can't just, like, severely out-level or get under-leveled against them. And just, like, sweep with one thing. Of course, if I did have, like, one massively over-leveled thing, so would they. Which would make it fair, but, you know. Right, who's next? It is... Nudes! Okay, right. See, that's the thing, I've got no idea what it's going to do. Like, my gut is saying it's going to go Giga Drain. But it could Leap Seed, it could Spore, it could Sub. It could do anything. Sub, yeah. Right. Hopefully it doesn't use Spore, hopefully it goes for Leap Seed, because then I can just burn it to death, because it ain't surviving Flamethrower nowhere. A Giga Drain, that's the last thing I thought it would go for. Because, yeah, that's not going to do anything. But, yeah, should have survived a Flamethrower. Yep. Oh, and a crit, just to rub it in. Absolutely tragic. Alright, next is... The D! Alright, definitely don't want to stay in against this. Ah, that's the thing. He's got Sludge Bomb. That means Nudes is going to take some damage from it. She should take a couple of hits from it, at least. So, yeah, there's the Earthquake. Yeah, it does no damage. So, Sludge Bomb's gonna come out. Should I just Giga Drain? Yeah, I'm just gonna Giga Drain. Like, Dugtrio's frail. Very frail. Oh my god! Took it so comfortably, holy crap. Reflect didn't even up. Oh, he survived. That's, unexpected. Not surviving the second one though, no chance. Yeah, I was debating on using Thank you. I was debating on using the fucking Bright Powder. God damn it. You
gonna go down. Ooh! Are you... Can we not do this, please? Bright Powder's not save me. Right, fine. You want to play with the D? I'll play with the D. Go with a proper mirror match. Also wins the speed type. There you go. Then last is Lonnie. Okay, so Seth, Hayes, Heal Bell, and Light Screen. If Nudes wasn't like on no HP, she could solo, but no, let's go with Rudra. He's got Earthquake, he's got good special defense, he can take it easy. Ooh, did quite a bit. Probably gonna take a couple of Earthquakes to take Valani down, she's got a lot of HP. Ooh, on Light Screen, really? That's a very poor choice. Should have gone for Surf again, dear. Oh, and there we go. You lost, or I lost. I don't even get any money from that. Great job. Now you know where your weaknesses are. Well, I already did, but like, thank you. Yeah, that was certainly an interesting fight. Did I get healed after that? I did. Okay, good. Yeah, that was an interesting fight. Very evenly matched. Well, I say that I didn't lose a single mon, but. Yeah, that was very interesting. Very fun. And now we get to some bullshit. Let's go to Misty's gym. Is Nude still up front? No, I switched to King Earth for the mirror match. I'm gonna have to deal with these. Don't let my elegant swimming unnerve you. Whatever you say, dear. Whatever you say. Brianna. Oh, fuck yeah, Sea King! What level are you, anyway? 56. Yeah, that's fine. Hey, yeah, just Giga Drain it straight out. Shouldn't be an issue. It's not like Sea King's, the best mon in the world here. Like, even in Gen 1 and Gen 2, Sea King was bad. It's only gotten worse over time with the power creep. Lapras on the other hand. This is very tanky, so it's probably going to survive and hit me with an Ice Beam or a Blizzard. And that's going to hurt. Yeah, there's Ice Beam. And the question is, how much is it going to do? A lot, okay. Well, I'll take some of that health back, thank you very much. Good boy! Then, fuck yeah, another Sea King! So, interesting fact about Sea King is that for... Well, actually, no, it's... It was like for a long time, but Sea King and Goldeen were like the only Pokemon to learn Waterfall by leveler. Oh, you can't really dispose of me, but I think it's... Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, Gyarados actually gets Waterfall by level up. And it's like at level 21 as well, so it's really goddamn good. Parker! What do you got, a Kingdra? Okay. So, should be easy enough to deal with. The main problem with this is gonna be my PP for Giga Drain. Twister, that's nothing. It's like the water gun of dragon moves, only 40 power,
got a chance to flinch though, and I think it hits both of them to the double battle. Not like that's relevant in this game, but just in case you decide to use it in the future, in, you know, another game. I don't remember what the flinch chance is. Is it like 20%, 30%? Oh yeah, and it can also hit Pokemon that are in the air, either by fly or bounce. So watch out for that. Another one to go. You just gotta have three Kingra, really. Agility, that's fine. And I've we've got 2 Gigadrains left. Oh no, you're faster than me now. You might make me flinch. You fiend! How dare you? There we go, thank you. Is this gonna kill? No, just barely misses out. Let me sub then. I don't want to waste my last Gigadrain on that little HP. Come on. Right, there you go. And another Kingdra. Congratulations, I think you have more Kingdras in this gym than in the Dragon one. Yeah, let me put up a sub. Now put it to sleep and get it with my last Gigadrain. Alright, sleep time. And now a Gigadrain for the finish. Yes, it's a 20% chance to flinch, and if it hits you while you are using fly or bounce, it will do double damage, so that could be something, I guess. Okay, Parker, down you go. This can't be. Oh, but it is. Yeah, let me go back and heal first. Alright, back we go. Right. What do you have? Well, why are you waiting? Let's get on with it. I'm waiting for you to get over here. Diana. What do you got? A Golduck. Okay. Golduck? Level 58, that's fine. Can I just kill you with the Gigadrain, or are you gonna be an asshole and survive it? Oh, you bitch! Like the smallest sliver. Right, I'm not wasting another one. Get some of this. Psycho? Okay. Whatever helps you sleep at night. Quag! Right, this thing's going down. 4 times weak. Ooh, I like that purple colour on it. I don't think it's quite its shiny colours, but it's fairly similar. It looks pretty good on it. I think Shiny Quag say is more of a pink than a purple. And then Slowbro! Slowbro's not got the greatest special defence, but it's got like a fuck ton of HP, so it might survive. Lucky Slowbro comes the colour of its shell as well. there's not worse when it lives with, like, the smallest bit of HP. Because you either have to waste another move or to do damage or, like, do some residual that really shouldn't be needed. Oh, nice. My nudes are at level 70. I give up, you're the winner. I am, it's true. Right, I'm not going back to the center again for this, I'll just use an elixir. I've got plenty of them. No, I won't need to heal either. I'm fine. Hi, you're a new face. Any trainer who wants to turn pro has a policy about Pokemon. What's your approach when you catch Pokemon? I use, like, the most jank shit available, usually. And favorite stuff. My policy is an all-out offense with water types. Ah, yes. An all-out offense with the most defensive type. Alright, there's another Golda. At level 58 as well, okay. Yeah, for all the... Ow. For all the problems Sword and Shield had, it did have banging music. And, it's battles. Specifically, well, mainly, obviously the gym leader theme was really good. The battle tower theme. So good, like, absolute perfection. Probably, like, one of my favourite trainer themes ever. But, like, it was done by Toby Fox, so, like, it's not even a surprise. Like, the man just composes masterpieces every time he fucking gets on a music-making software. Alright, down goes the dupe. What you got next? Oh! Oh, yeah, I forgot you had that. I didn't know you had that. Yeah, you've got the ever-popular water-type Lugia. And you can't hit me for shit, apparently. That's fine. Yes, I still don't get why Lugia's not part water. Like, why is it part psychic? It should 100% be water flying. This ain't gonna do much for her. See, this is why I chose to run Fire Blast over Blizzard on Ninetales. Even though it's got the same power as Fire Blast, Blizzard's got less accuracy. It's 70%. I believe Thunder is the same. But Thunder's accuracy can at least be mitigated by using Rain Dance. Which makes it bypass all evasion and accuracy checks. Unfortunately for Blizzard, Hail doesn't exist yet. That wasn't until Gen 3. And when Hail's up, that makes Blizzard 100% accurate. And there's also the little oddity in Gen 4, Diamond and Pearl specifically, not Platinum, where if you use Blizzard or Rain Dance, Blizzard or Thunder in Hail or the Rain, then there is a slight chance the opposite of its normal accuracy, so it'd be 30% in both cases, where it can just go through Protect. I've personally never seen that happen because I just, like, don't really use Blizzard or Thunder. But that was quickly changed in Platinum. Because I imagine that would be quite broken in double battles. Oh, Perish Song, really? Wait, is this going to work on me? It still says bow, so... Yeah. Right, so that still goes through sub. Interesting. Yeah, that must have been, would have been fairly interesting in double battles. Just a 30% chance to just break through Protect, which is a very important move in doubles. Ooh, Stammy, hello.
Do I want to attack? I've only got 2 Giga Drains left. Now, I'll spoil you. Just can't get touched by that Blizzard. Alright, Periscope is at 1, so I'm going to switch out. Yeah, that's the thing, I don't really have a good switch. I guess Rudra? Probably should have put Thunderbolt back on Lani for this. Because I don't think I'm really going to need either Haze or... Well, no, I have used Heal Bell a few times, but that was mainly because... I mainly only used it because I wasn't able to use items. Now that I'm able to, I can just heal back up with them. Alright, back to nudes. Need to take out this Quagsire with Giga Drain. Yeah, that's not gonna do much. Quagsire is not the best attacker in the world, especially special-wise. Alright, down he goes. Goddamn, Nudes is just like climbing right up on the level ladder. And the last one is Octobastard. Nice. You're gonna flamethrow, aren't you? Let me put you to sleep. Thankfully, Octillery is really, really slow. I don't think this is gonna kill. I probably should have used Leech Seed first. I like, it's... Oh, no, it just killed. Oh, it's the same as Sword and Shield. Where, once you get there on the leader on the last Pokemon, the music changes. It does that in this as well. Which is a really nice touch. You really are good. I'll admit that you're skilled. Here you go, it's the Cascade Badge. I got some money. Were you gonna give me, like... I mean, you can't give me Seth. Team 14, that's... Blizzard? Really? The team will teach you Blizzard, yeah. Might not be a water move, but many water types can learn it. I mean, yeah, I don't think there is a water TM, is there? Why do I have 3 Blizzards? Where did I get the other 2? Well, I probably got one in Seafoam Islands. Where did the other one come from? I don't know. Alright, here we are in Celadon City. And this is where Erica is. Before I go there, I want these. Not really going to put them on anyone. I just forgot to pick them up the first time I was here. So, we're going to take on the Grass Gym. I've already put Fubuki up front. Which means that this is going to be a cakewalk. We'll show you Pokemon moves that Erica taught us. Well, isn't that nice? I'm sure you can use them very effectively, dears. Joan Zoe. Victory Bell at level 61, yes. Still got the level advantage, that's fine. Might get out-leveled by the time I get to Gym 16. Down you go. Finally get that level on Fubuki. Yeah, she's absolutely just gonna clean in here. And Vileplume, yeah, that's pretty standard. Those two are counterparts. Which makes me hope that Weakenbill will get an alternate evolution one of these days to Mirror Blossom. Oh, we lost. He did. Like, make it just, like, pure poison or something instead of pure grass. Oh, a battle? That's kind of scary, but okay. Oh, it's a fun fact. I got him, I just followed him today, aren't I? So as far as I'm aware, Gloom is the only Pokemon that will lose a typing. Like, that goes from a dual type to a single type when it evolves into Blossom. Because Gloom is grass poison, and then Blossom is only pure grass type. And I think that's the only Pokemon in the franchise that does that. Like, obviously there's ones that, like, gain a different
secondary type sometimes from evolving. Like, Sersket is a bug water type, but when it evolves to Masquerain, it becomes bug flying. But yeah, I'm pretty sure Blossom's the only one to lose a typing upon evolution. Just always found that pretty neat. Alright, down goes Meganium. A lot of experience there, nice. Yeah, Fubuki's gonna be absolutely jacked coming out of this gym. Oh, that's it? Yeah, I know, right? Do you think a Gale's only gym is rare? No, because Goldenrod is also the same way. Jump off. I don't know why I said like, it's not gonna outspeed me. Like, Jump off is fast, but it's not like outspeed something 11 levels higher than you're fast. Are you gonna have three? Yeah. Looks that way. They're all gonna fall the same way, dear. And then down this goes. Marvelous. Easy. Hello, Blair. Oh, shut up. Right, just the one more, that's fine. Were you looking at these flowers or at me? I was looking at Erica, to be honest. She's the one right in front of me. Oh, Parasect. Oh, you poor, poor thing. You're gonna get barbecued. You're absolutely gonna get sizzled. Wouldn't be funny if you had dry skin as well, but unfortunately that doesn't exist yet. Not until Gen 4. Allows the user to absorb water moves, but in exchange you become weaker to fire. By, I want to say 50%, but it might actually be double. You also take damage in the sunlight and heal in the rain. Pretty decent ability, good for certain things like Toxicroak and Jinx that don't really have like better options. Because like, what's Jinx's other ability? Like, Oblivious? It's not great, it just prevents Attract. And I think it prevents Taunt in later generations as well. I think it might prevent Intimidate in Gen 9 as well, because I know they did a lot of stuff to nerf that. Then, what's Toxicroak's ability? Anticipation? Which just lets you know if the foe's got a super effective move. Hello, lovely weather, isn't it? It's so pleasant. My name is Erica, and I'm the leader of Celadon Gym. I'm afraid I made those off. I'm sorry, I didn't realise that you wished to challenge me. Why else would I be here, dear? Very well, but I shall not lose.
I mean, I'm barbecued like everybody else in the gym in one shot. I don't think you're gonna fare much better, dear. Especially not when you're leading with that.
Ooh, 64 though. That's a little bit of a step up from other stuff.
It's not going to help you because you've got no special defense, but
yeah, a bit of a step up.
Good boy!
So you've got six now. What have you got? Venusaur. So, like, Tangela, Venusaur, Victreebel, Vileplume, Blossom, and something else, probably. Oh, wait, no, yeah, I remember what your something else is. I won't spoil it, but we have seen it before.
Something, really?
But we have seen it before. Really? Celebi? That's the best thing you could have done? Like, you could have at least used Sludge Bomb, do more damage.
There's the other thing!
Celebi, level 70. Ooh. Their levels are getting on up now. Okay. This might survive, yeah, because base 100 all around. Which is quite a bit above average in Gen 2. A hyper potion, really. Yeah, base 100 HP and base 100 special defense is really goddamn good in this game. Not enough to save from a 2-hit KO, but still good. Right, so down goes the onion. What about next? It is jump off. Oh, so she's left one of them behind her. Well, not left one behind her.
One of the things she has is not what I think, and
knowing this game, it's probably going to be the Molossum, because, like, why would you have variety in this game? There's the victory bell, so the last one is probably the Vileplume. Like, I'm not trying to rag on the game or anything, it's just when there's there's a fair different variety of grass type. Oh no, she does have Blossom. Alright. I stand corrected. I will apologize. I'm sorry for going off like that. Or well, I was about to, but yeah, consider me corrected. I thought Vileplume would be on the team. Come on. Yeah, Blossom's got pretty good special defense as well. Hail Dance is, like, pretty weak in this game. It's, like, 70 power. Oh my gosh, come on. Yeah, it's only got 70 power, and I believe Outrage has 90. The Rampage... Another crit, really? The Rampage moves have become, like, really good until Gen 4. There we go. Yeah, the Rampage moves became, like, 120 power later on. Made them really good, especially if you got a stab on them. Oh, I can seek defeat. You're remarkably strong. I shall give you the Rainbow Badge. And a lot of money. That's what I really wanted. And I'm guessing you're going to give me Giga Drain or maybe Solar Beam. Felt inspired, please. I wish you to have this TM. It's Giga Drain, yeah. Yeah, I know Giga Drain works. I've been using it all game. Losing leaves a bitter aftertaste, but knowing there are strong trainers spurs me to do better. Well, that's nice, because I'm probably going to grind on you later on once I need to get some levels for Fubuki. We're going to be taking on Blaine's gym. And it's only just occurred to me that the last gyms I left in Kanto are the Fire, Water, Grass ones. Which is... I don't know, it's pretty amusing, just like the most like basic core. Actually, now I'm gonna be in the fairy place. That's where the computer is. But yeah, just like the most like basic type core. Just funny how those three were the ones I just happened to leave, because I haven't really done the gyms in like any particular order or anything. I just go for whichever one I feel like going for at the time. Right, and I need to move Kenya first. Right, I mean, I probably should have just left Kenya in the party, because, like, there's no way I'm bringing nudes to this fight. Oh yeah, so off screen, I went to Viridian Forest, I caught this Sudowoodo, and I also caught this Kangaskhan. It's holding a Pokédoll, okay. So this is, this Kangaskhan was the one that was in Viridian Forest, and it was weird because it was poisoned when I fought it, and I don't know why. It didn't have a story event or anything, it was just, like, there and poisoned. Right, so... Right, let's get the D some action, shall we? I haven't used it for a while. You know what? There's two ways to go. Been hot in this gym, catch on fire any moment. One of the best gym leaders, good luck. So, is there a difference? So, Officer Merchant is reporting for duty. Alright. Yeah, I don't know if there's a difference in the way you go, but... Oh, Doom! Level 61. This should be good experience. Very good. Nice evolved Pokemon at a decent level. Lane's probably going to be like level 75 now, isn't he? That would make sense, because...
I know that the Pokemon League rematch, the champion is level 90.
That was a dead end.
Yeah, I know the champion's at level 90.
So Blaine's at like 75, Whitney's at 80. Then that'll be a good jump in levels. Why is this one 67? Like, the Houndoom I just fought was 61. Why is this just, like, jumped up? And he's got two of them! And that's not even a fire type! I mean, okay.
I don't think it's got anything dangerous. Like, Slash is probably its best thing.
Oh, Furious Lights apparently, and it just done it over there. Marvelous. Always get the crits when I don't need it.
Get rusty after a while. Ooh, that's a lot of money.
Blaze it!
Oh, is this the weird guy? Let me guess, he's got a grass type. Like an oddish or something.
Ooh, Charizard.
You're gonna make a good rock slide bit.
So we've got that stealth drop doesn't exist yet, Charizard. You're safe for two more gens.
Or one, even. It's a gen 4 it happened.
Got lost him. Yeah, he would have had a... he would have had an oddish if you went and fought him early. So, yeah, it's just a weird joke.
This might not kill you.
Ooh. That probably will if it hits me, but it's not going to.
It just suddenly pulls out the quick claw. Wouldn't surprise me.
Farewell.
How much money am I getting from this?
6,000. Very nice.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, actually, don't know what the puzzle in this gym is. I guess just pulling switches to... Oh, this is just the shortcut to the end. But this guy's here, anyway. Alright.
Right now, else.
Okay. Fight me! If you want to get to Berlin, you gotta battle me! Well, yeah, you're in the way. And I would have fought you anywhere. April.
Flareon, okay. That'll be easy to take out.
Great special defense, but not so great physical defense.
Or HP.
I mean, it might survive, you never know.
Okay, good.
Down you go. Alright, what we got next? Another not fire type?
No, we do, okay.
Oh, Ninetales! Ninetales, you're a bitch.
Please go down to an earthquake. I would very much appreciate that.
Thank you. Highly illogical.
What, me using the D against you?
And then this guy. Could build a stick to perfect medium rare inside this gym. To be honest, I'm not a big fan of Stay. I don't know if it's just the ones that I've had from the takeaways before, and like they haven't been proper grill places, but yeah, they haven't been really good. And they've always been like really chewy and just not full of taste, not much flavour. If I'm able to get one from like a proper grill house, then I think that's a ferret. But I'll give that a try, but like, yeah, as it stands, I'm not that big a fan of steak, so I'm not really familiar with the whole well done, medium rare, like argument stuff, because I know that's like a big point of contention on like how much you cook it. And I just don't get it. I'm not a steak person. I've only had two before. There's another Flareon. Just like the last one, should go down to a single EQ. Definitely will with a crit. Alright, what's your last one? Ninetales? Oh, Typhlosion, hello! It's always nice to see regular trainers with a starter. No, it just makes them feel like a bit more real. Since, you know, like, everyone did start out on their journey at one point. Whoa! Alright, there we go. Do I need to heal those earthquakes? 5. Yes, I absolutely do, because he's gonna have at least one legendary. I don't know which one, but he's gonna have something. It's either gonna be Moltres or Entei. Knowing my luck, at this stage, probably both. Ha! The old gym burned down! My fire-breathing Pokemon and I were homeless because of the volcano, and we had to live in a cave! But then, I had a great idea. Why not make the lava work for me? Now we've rebuilt, and we're back in business running the Cinnabon gym. Hotter and better than ever! You'd better have Burn Heal! No, I've got full restores and full heals, so hopefully that'll be good enough for your lane. Let's do this. Macargo, yeah, that's going down easy. Ooh, starting out at 70. So yeah, he's probably going to be at 75 with his ace. Or aces. He's going to have both. Like, I'm calling it now. Like, what's he going to have? He's going to have, like, Macargo, definitely Magmar. Probably Houndoom, Entei, Moltres, and then like, I don't know, Typhlosion, Charizard, something like that. There's not really much variety for fire types yet. Yep, there's the Moltres. Level 72, okay, so that's not too bad. That is agility. Unless it's got Solar Beam, there's just not really much Moltres can do. I mean, there's that. Fire Blast is gonna hurt me. It might even take me out. Which would be, you know, pretty bad. Okay, good. There we go, we hit this time, thank you. See, how hard was that? Ooh. I wasn't expecting it to survive that. Plan B. Let's go, Lani. Oh, I could have just done it again. Oh, whatever. Like, yeah, I don't think it's got Solar Beam or like Hidden Power Electric or anything, because that seems like it's the best thing you can do. And with a light screen up, it's not gonna do very much at all. Get that wave riding up. How did, like, a Surf do almost as much as a 4x super effective Rock Slide? Like, I know Rock Slide's not stab, but, like, Moltres is double weak to it, and I don't think his defense is that good. Thank you. Hugo. The D levels up. And so does Lanny. Nice. Almost 300 HP. Goddamn. Right, there's the Houndoom. Alright, Moltres was his ace, and that was 72, so... Right, not quite 75. That's fine. Means I don't have a big deficit to worry about. God, that light screen is just so good. I just take no damage from any special moves. It's great. Right, down you go. Next is Arcanine. How can I forget Arcanine? Well, pretty easy actually, I don't really like Arcanine. Yeah, I know, heresy to some people probably, because it's just a big dog. I don't like dogs. I don't care for dogs. Come on. I'm definitely more of a cat person, just not a fan of dogs in the slightest. I don't like how they always want to jump up at me. I just like the space. I don't like getting hair all over my clothes. Yep, there's the magma. With cross chop, interesting. It's actually a legit move magma can learn. It's an egg move, I believe. Not 100% sure if it can get it in Gen 2, but I think from Gen 3 it can. Oh yeah, Rapidash, you exist. Okay, so he's not got Entei. I'll show you the spirit of New Cinnabar Island. Oh, Hypnosis, yeah. I'm glad that missed. That's probably going to survive. Oh no, okay, good.
Oh, gone!
I should have leveled me up.
Awesome, I've burned out. You've earned a volcano badge.
And a lot of money.
Hang on a sec.
Boink.
Haha, gotta love the new gym. Alright, here's your new badge.
I received the volcano badge.
I did lose this time, but I'm going to win the next one. We'll have to have a rematch. Oh, before I forget, you can take this TM too.
And he gives you Fire Blast for winning.
TM38 is a blazing Fire Blast. You'd be surprised at how many Pokémon can learn this fantastic move.
Yeah, like Gyarados and Rhydon. Some pretty stupid things can learn it. Okay, that's Blaine down, which means we should only have Whitney to go. Because, all the Kanto badges. And just little old Whitney. Okay then, we're in Goldenrod City, and it's time for the final gym. Whitney's gym. The normal gym. Give it your best shot, or I'll take you down. Yeah, sure. Oh yeah, we're in Johto now, so different music. Right, Sam Mantha, what you got? A cat, okay. Level 72, yeah, this is gonna be easy. Just gonna kill him. Chop him up. And save him to the Chinese again. I think the Chinese eat cats as well. I know they eat dogs. Don't know about cats. And it's another Persian. That should be fine. I don't think that Screech is really going to make a difference. Would have made a difference if I kept missing, but... Thankfully, it didn't come to that. Ooh, quite nice. Makes absolutely no difference, but... It's always nice to see him. No, I'm so sorry. Good, you better be. Give me all your fucking money as well, you bitch. Yeah. We have a purple bitch here. Oh, you're a cute little trainer. I like you, but I won't hold back. I mean, thanks, I guess. You're the one with the forts, right? Vicky. Vic. 64. But what is with these level jumps? Like, it's evolving, but backwards. It's weird.
Oh, another crit. Nice.
Yep, another crit. And then 68. Why is it like this?
Oh, another crit. Damn. Ruger's on a roll.
Yeah, then a third for it. At 72. Another crit! Holy crap! Like, Rudra, can you calm down? Save these for the gym leader, please, because, yeah, absolutely gonna fucking need them for them. I think there's only two trainers left now? Yeah, there's this one, and then there's the one in front of Whitney. Don't let my Pokemon's cute looks fool you, they can whip you- what, excuse me? Carrie, I'm gonna need you to explain. Grand roll, okay. Like, whip- I'm guessing it means whip as in, like, whip- ow. I don't- why did I say ow? I just missed. Whip as in, like, you know, whip your lot, but I guess? I don't know. Crit? Damn. The streak has ended. It's over. Dan, I thought you were weak. No, I've got Heracross. I'm, like, unstoppable. I like cute Pokemon better than strong Pokemon. But I have cute and strong Pokemon. Well, isn't that nice for you? I don't know. I'd say Lantern's pretty cute. Brigitte. With a fat Wigglytuff. Level 70. That's a chunky lad. Oh, yeah. I've only got... 8 PP on that. I'm gonna have to elixir before Whitney. Wigglytuff is like surprisingly frail. Oh my god. Just as I said that, and then it survives, like instantly proving me wrong. But yeah, it's got like really good HP, but its defenses aren't fantastic. Or even good. So it kind of balances out. Another Wigglytuff. Can I kill with this one, please? I'd very much appreciate it. Son of a bitch. Defense scale, that's not gonna help you, I'm afraid. I'm guessing a third Wigglytuff? Yep. Cool. Right, stab it. Did less damage that time. Right, down you go. Kindly get out of my life. Alright, there we go. Okay, now it's time for our final gym leader. Right, let me elixir Rudra and heal him up, because that'll be quite beneficial. And it's time to go. Hi, I'm Whitney. Everyone was into Pokemon, so I got into it too. Pokemon are super cute. Oh, you want a battle? I'm warning you, I'm good. Yes, I know you are, honey. That's why I saved you for last. Right, full team of six. What you got? Starting out with a Clefable. That's understandable. You usually have a Clefairy. Go for a meditate first, and then, yeah, just cleared up shop with Cross Chop. Icy Wind. I bet that minus speed's gonna fuck me over. Well, we'll find out later in the battle, won't we? Right, Clefable goes down. There's a Wigglytuff. 75, then. Lots of animus, though. No chance. Stantler! I forgot you existed, to be honest. Ooh, I'm very glad that missed. But yeah, if Stan was outspeeding me, then that's not good. Alright, level 70 for the lad. Another Tauros, we fought one of them already today. Crash, that's gonna deal a chunk. Ah! Yeah, Tauros is like deceptively strong. It was like one of the best mons in Gen 1. Right, there's the Miltank, level 75. Roll out, yeah, I'm not worried about that in the slightest. And down it goes. And finally, our ultimate mon. Missy! Or like a big chunk of experience. Unless I miss. Oh no. Yeah, Bliss has got base 10. Oh my god. Yeah, Bliss has got base 10 attack. Any physical attacks it does are just like not gonna do anything. There we go. It's also got base 10 physical defense, which means that any physical attack you throw at it, especially a fighting one, is gonna do a chunk of damage. Base 255 HP though, so it's quite tanky. And don't use special attacks on it. You're mean! Where, yeah, sorry. I do love you, Whitney, but it had to be done. Oh, you want a badge? Oh, I forgot. Here you go. Here's the plane badge. And I think she's going to give me a tract. Felicia Pokemon's Charm. Heffer Acuity. Yep. And with that, that is every single gym badge. So what is there to do now besides challenge the Pokemon League again? Well, I get stuck on a bunch of walls, that's one thing. But yeah, there is a trainer that has spawned since we became the Pokemon League champion. And we're gonna go take him on. Right now, in fact. Because, why not, right? Haven't been going for terribly long. Right, you just sitting there for a hot second, Ruga, while I get fly, because I'm not walking all the way there. I mean, you already know who it is. You already know I'm gonna go fight. You already know where I'm going. And if you don't, then you should. So yes, we are here at Mount Silver. This is where one of our ultimate opponents awaits. And the original ultimate opponent. So we'll pop Kenya back in the box. Grab a Rudra. And we'll stick the D up front, why not? And yeah, we're gonna make the trek up Mount Silver. After this wild battle. Hello, horse. How are you doing? Oh my god, why is your animation so long? Why do you have zero in attack? Get out of here. You're a waste of my time. Okay, right. I'm gonna max repel this bitch. And we're gonna head up Mount Silver. For the second time. On screen. I skipped most of the trip up Mount Silver the first time because I was trying to remember about the Moltres clue, and I thought the girl said like it was in Mount Silver, not Victory Road. But yeah, I was wrong. So yeah, once you beat the Pokemon League and you come here, there will be a trainer waiting for you. And as I said earlier in the video, depending on who it is you started as, will depend on who is waiting here for you. In some cases, it will be red. In some cases, it will be ether/gold. And I think in some other cases, it can be either Leaf or Crystal.
I'm not 100% sure. I'll have to look that up. But
we have our team ready-ish. Level 69 through 73. Which is a pretty good benchmark, I think. It's time to take on Red. And as in the base game, he leads with a level 81 Pikachu. Is it holding a light ball? Probably. Does it have good defense? Not at all. Yeah, it might be a level 81 Pikachu, but it's still a Pikachu. It's got no defense. So, probably Blastoise, right? No, Venusaur, right? Okay. That's fine. Yeah, then the rest of his team is like in the high 70s. So, there shouldn't be too much of a challenge for my team. I've, like, beaten higher levels than this before. But the thing with Red's team is, it is quite diverse. Like, obviously, he's got all three of the starters. He's got Pikachu, he's got Espeon, and then he's got Snorlax. In Heart Gold and Soul Silver, he switches out Espeon for Lapras. Which... I mean, it's certainly a choice. But, like, he doubles up on water types. So, like, I prefer the Espeon pick. Sludge Bomb, that's fine. But yeah, he's got like varied moves and stuff. Like he's got Giga Drain, he's got poisoning. I think he's probably got Solar Beam on this thing. Charizard has got like Flamethrower, and that's all I really know. Blastoise, I believe, has Blizzard. Snorlax, I believe, has Rest and like Shadow Ball. Oh. Okay, so they've been given different items. So what that was the Berserk Gene. It's basically like Swagger, but an item on yourself. So your attack goes up by 2 stages, but it confuses you. So that's enough to tell me that this is a physical Charizard. So it's probably got, yeah, Rock Slide. So I'm gonna set that Reflect up right now. It's probably still got, like, Flamethrower and stuff, so I'm not going to send in Noobs. I'm going to send in King instead. Hopefully it'll smack itself a couple of times. Okay, good. And I'm going to paralyze it, because Charizard is quite a speedy lad. But as you can see, he's also very stupid. So yeah, this is Parafusion, but, oh my god. I was going to say this is Paraflinch Fusion, but then he still got through it. And he delivered a crit, that's marvellous, okay. What a prick. Good to know there's still bullshit in play in this fight. Down goes Charizard. Next is probably going to be Snorlax, I want to say. Ooh, nice, level 70, because I think it's... Well, if since the moves have changed, it's probably got... Espeon. It's probably got, like, Earthquake. Let me light screen. Ooh, growth. I don't like that. Right, let me Haze first. I don't fancy taking a plus one. Ah, that is, and that's with light screen up. This might be a bit of a risk, but I'm gonna send in Nudes. Yeah, definitely don't want to be taking a plus one from Espeon. And I'm going to spore it now. But yeah, the moves have changed, so... they might have, they've definitely got more specialised move. Don't tell me that's a Miracle Berry. No, that's fine. Less damage on me for now. Right. Let's Leech Seed it. Hopefully I'll, it'll stay asleep for a couple of turns so it doesn't just, like, wake up and one-shot me, because... Yeah, you saw how much damage I was taking even with the light screener. Okay, Giga Drain. Still asleep, that's marvellous. Espeon's got pretty decent special defense, so this isn't going to do a terrible amount of damage. Yeah, that's okay. And still asleep, excellent. Is this going to finish it off, or is it about to live on a slither like usual things, like things usually do? Yes, it is. I'm going to take this opportunity to revive King. No sense in attacking because it's going to go down to Leech Seed this turn. Okay, good. Stays asleep. Which means I get to keep my sub. So, he's got Snorlax and Blastoise left. Right, this is the big boy. This is the thing you need to worry about. Like I said, Snorlax has got massive HP, it's got massive special defense. Its defense is already decent, so is its attack. If this thing has Chaos, I'm gonna be in trouble. Big time. Oh, it's got Snort, okay. So that means it's definitely got Rest. And it's got Leftovers, that's not a surprise in the slightest. This. Oh, Amnesia. Ooh, yeah. Right, special attacks are absolutely useless here, then. So it's going to have, like, Rest, Snore, Amnesia. Or, like, Body Slam or something. Shadow Ball, maybe, to deal with Ghost types, because otherwise it just can't hit him. Alright! And... Why'd the music reset? Okay. But yeah, this is his Blastoise now, and I missed because of course it is. Should be easy enough to take out, you know, as long as I can, like, hit it. Like, it's just like a standard water type, like, pretty bulky. Decent special attack, especially with the Rain Dancer. But it's no match for Rouge's Mega Horn. And I got money for winning. Soothing wind blows through the room. A voice began to echo. Hey, up. When you found yourself with nothing left to conquer, come find me in the forge. Okay. Okay, so let's head on over to the forge. If you don't have Surf, you can take this shortcut through... Oh, Yellow's back. I wonder if she's got a updated team. Let's take her on, shall we? You find my secret fishing spot. A battle? Okay. Yeah, I imagine she's got a updated team. Yeah, full team of 6 now, what's she got? Right! Yeah, level 78. Alright, so yeah, we've got Yellow as well. So, it's just Eradicate with extreme speed. It's actually going to deal a lot of damage. Level 78, so yeah, her levels are pretty decent. That other extreme speed is going to kill me, so... Let's pop some nudes in.
Super Fang. Yeah, I thought so.
Give me some of that elf back, thank you. It's mine.
Oh, you bitch.
I'll just leave see that. I'm gonna have to... Alright, let me switch to the D. Because Super Fang is probably coming out again, and it can't kill you. Even if you're at 1 HP, it'll do 0 damage. That's a Butterfree, not a cat, but... Alright. Hopefully this should kill it. It's frailer than Moltres. Okay, good. It was a crit, but let's just pretend it didn't. Dirty. That's... Hey, Dodrio! You've probably got extreme speed as well, haven't you? Yeah, let's get King in here. Let's paralala-size it and try to flinch. This is gonna hurt though. Dodrio's like strong.
High jump kick!
I know you get that in later generations, but come on. Yeah, let me recover. Either wait for a miss or a fully para. Because, yeah, I don't want to take the risk in letting King go down. Due to a headbutt not killing. Or flinching, not paralyzing. If you could stop for a second, that'd be great. There we go, finally. I'd just like to, like, point out that I never get that lucky with breaking through paralysis. Oh my god, that did no damage. Oh, but that did. Excuse me, why did that do nothing? I thought this was the game where if you missed with high jump kick, then you take damage equal to like 25% or 50% of what you would have done to them. But okay. That's a golem. That's... Oh, yeah, but noobs, I'm fine. Epic's not gonna kill, Giga Drain will. Or at least do like a massive chunk. And I'll get a hella amount of HP back. Delicious. There we go. Ho ho! Very nice. Then Choo Choo is. Another Pikachu, really? Level 80. With Hell Dance, really? I mean, it's good coverage for it, but why the hell is it using it on my Tangela? Like, Thunderbolt would have done more damage. Like, much more. It's already, like, stronger than Hell Dance, and it's also stab. Sure, whatever. Yeah, just another Giga Drain to finish you off. Ow. But yeah, you're only doing 20 damage. Alright, what's left? Omni. Oh, my star, that's fine. Are you gonna Ice Beam me? Last one, you can do it, Omni. Oh, I'm faster. Bit surprising, but, yeah, Omni Star's, not really the fastest thing in the world. Hey, some nudes leveled up.
You're strong.
I am. You're pretty good at battling. I think I'll head out soon. Maybe I can find somewhere else to fish. Got weird, really. Useful as ever, Wade. Thank you. Goddamn. I really should just delete his number, because he just doesn't say anything fucking useful. Yeah, he's not in here. He needs to go to the forge, so let's make our way to the forge. Alrighty then, I'm in Viridian City now. So, I went to the forge to see Shockslayer. There was just nout there for me. Like, I tried to talk to him, he just said that he just wanted to battle me. Swinehub didn't do anything. Apparently, so I looked at a walkthrough guide type thing, and apparently if you've found 7 differently coloured Swinehubs over the regions, then you get like 25 rare candies from him. But I hadn't done that. So I'm going to end the part. That sprite looks like so weird because of the colour. I'm going to end the part re-challenging blue, because I've fought red, I've fought yellow. We've got the final colour to take down. Heh, think you got another one in you? I sure hope so. So yeah, let's round out this part. That is not a good lead for me. Oh no, wait, yeah it is. Haha, I'm a genius. It was calculated, don't worry guys. I know exactly what I had at the front. I definitely didn't think I still had Diddy up front. Okay, so down goes Eggy. What's next? It is right on. Spinning that drill. Yeah, nudes. Let's go. Probably an earthquake or a rock slide coming my way, or a roll out. Okay, let me just put you to sleep. I'm gonna be honest, I didn't even know Rhydon could land Rollout. That's like throwing me for a fucking loop. I mean, it might be exclusive to this, but like, it's still weird. Because like, could you just imagine like a Rhydon curling up into a ball and rolling it? That's already hard to imagine, but then imagine it with friggin' Rhyperia doing it. Something distinctively not very round. Well, at least not ball-like. It's like roundish, but more like it's very angular. Is what I'm trying to get at. That's gonna kill my sub for sure. All right, let's put up the seeds as per the use, and switch over to Lamy. Oh, she's at 300 HP now, wonderful. A nice round number. Extreme speed, yeah, that's standard. And this is also standard, taking it out with Surf. Get out of it. Right, next day. I was not expecting this. Oh no. Fucking. Yeah, that's throwing me for a goddamn loop. Like, friggin' Mewtwo, really? Hopefully nudes can survive with light screen up.
amnesia again, you fool. Let me put you to sleep. Oh wow, getting greedy are you? Okay. Absolutely fine by me. That's less fine by me. So is that. Right, back to Lani. Yeah, thankfully, raising your special defense. Amnesia only raises special defense instead of just special, which in Gen 1 was also your special attack. That's what made Snorlax absolutely beastly. Because he used amnesia to raise his special defense and special attack at the same time. Which means he could also use stuff like Blizzard to deal a lot of damage. Okay, that's not great. I'm not outspeeding with Heracross nowhere. Oh yeah, and the music also changes when you're at a disadvantage. Or at least when you lose a mon. Just like in Sword and Shield, which is a nice touch. Ow. Alright, give me some HP back. Get your speed down. This is exactly why I'm running Icy Wind on Ninetales. There we go, I outspeed now. Oh, of course he's got Recover. Why wouldn't he? Well, hopefully I can get a banner with Flamethrower. I doubt it, but... you know. Ooh, Psychic. That's fine. I can kill next turn now. Ow. Oh, my God. I still think Mewtwo is, like, the king in Gen 2. Like, in Gen 1, there was, like, absolutely no contest. Mewtwo was the absolute best Pokémon. I'm not sure if the same is true in Gen 2, though. I don't think he is. Because, yeah, Psychic's not as busted in Gen 2 as it is in Gen 1. Yeah, because the only other thing to resist Psychic in Gen 1 is another Psychic. Oh, that's a Blastoise. I've no idea what I was looking at for a minute then. But yeah, that's why the Dark and Steel types were introduced. To, like, balance out Psychic. He's probably got Blizzard or Ice Beam, but... nah, I don't think I'm gonna let him do that. But yeah, Dark's just like completely immune to Psychic and Steel resists it. And then, a few years later in Gen 6, they brought out the Fairy type to deal with Dragon. Fairy's just completely immune to Dragon, and it's just so funny. Because you'll get something like a Garchomp dropping a Draco Meteor, and then you just send in like a tiny little puffball like Igglybuff, and it's just like, nope! Don't work! Try again! Lol. Lamau, even. Right, that takes care of the Blastoise. What have we got next? Is it... no, we won't have Gyarados anymore, will we? Oh yeah, this thing. This should be easy enough. Hey, you're unprepared for this. We'll knock you down. Yeah, sure, whatever you say, buddy. Oh, that's Sky Attack. Uh-oh. We can tank it. See? Easy. Okay, I'm glad that didn't flinch me.
Yeah, Sky Attack can flinch, and it also has a high crit rate. It's also like base 140 power. So it's pretty damn strong. I honestly forgot it existed in Gen 2. What the hell is going on with the music? Yeah, this is not a section I've heard before. Like, I know the music distorts sometimes when you use other moves, because like it can only play so many sound effects at the same time. But yeah, it just sounds like. Yeah, it sounded like it was just like stuck in that. But oh, I mean it's dead now anyway, so it don't matter. But yeah, I think Sky Attack existed in Gen 1. I can't remember who actually got it though. How could I lose? Well, easy, I like defeated all your Pokemon. You had a Mewtwo! Like, give it a rest. You don't need to train more. How do you even get one anyway? Oh wait, no. Yeah, I caught the clone Mewtwo, not the actual one. So yeah, that's probably the original. Oh well. So that is going to do it for this part. We have now achieved, acquired all 16 gym badges, which is quite the accomplishment, I'd say. So next, we're going to take on. I don't know. I might do all the gym leaders at full power. I might take on the league again. I'll decide when I start recording. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this part. And I'll see you in the next one. Cheers for watching, everybody.